Hello students, I am Bhavani. So the next topic in planning of audit is internal check as regards to payment of wages. First of all, to minimize the fraudulent manipulation of wage records, cash and other risks, the following internal check system can be adopted. They are maintenance of wage record, preparation of wage sheets and payment of wages. First one, maintenance of wage records. Time recording clock should be maintained for recording the time of workers entering and leaving the place of work. If the workers are paid on the basis of piece wages system, proper books for recording the actual work done by workers should be maintained. If workers are allowed to work overtime, overtime slips must be issued to such workers by properly authorized official. If any worker wants to go out of the factory, he should take written permission from the authorized person. If casual workers are also employed in the organization, a list of such workers must be prepared by the foreman of each department. The list so prepared must be certified by the officer who is authorized to appoint casual workers. Next one, preparation of wage sheets. The work of preparation of wage sheets should be done by a separate department. This work should be done at least by four clerks so that irregularities may be minimized. For instance, two clerks should examine the time records, piece wage records, overtime records, etc. The third clerk should prepare individual employee statements, that is, address of the worker, work done, and rate of wages. The fourth clerk should check the calculations and deduct the rent, provident fund, income tax, and installment of loans, etc. from the gross wages to arrive at the net amount to be paid to the worker. All these clerks should initial the wage sheets before they are signed by the works manager. Next, payment of wages. In payment of wages, the cashier should withdraw the net amount as shown in the wage sheets. The payment of wages must be made by a person who is in no way concerned with the preparation of wage sheets. Each worker who is to receive the wages should be present at the time of disbursement. The foreman of each department should be present at the time of payment to identify the workers of his section. The signatures of workers must be obtained when they receive the amount of wages. Special arrangement should be made to pay to the absentee workers. A list of unpaid workers should be prepared by the cashier and foreman of each department. The officer employing casual workers should not be connected with the payment of wages. As far as possible, casual workers should be paid wages on a day different from the payment day of regular workers. A surprise visit of a senior official while the wages are disbursed will be an effective measure of control. So we have to keep this point while checking the payment of wages. Next one, internal check as regarded to cash sales. For efficient working of a sales department, its activities can be arranged: sales over the counter, postal sales, sales by traveling. First one, sales over the counter. For each counter, a separate salesman should be appointed to look after his counter. Each salesman should be given a separate sales notebook. Such books should be of different colors for different counters. The salesman, when he sells the goods to the customers, he should prepare 3 copies of cash memo. One copy should be retained for preparing sales summary, and the remaining 2 copies should be handed over to the customer and instruct the customers to make payment at the cash counter. The cashier, after having received the price of the goods from the customer, should give one copy duly stamped as cash paid to the customer, and other copy must be retained by him. At the end of the day, the cashier should prepare statement showing total cash received, and the salesman should prepare sales summary to know the total sales. Then both these statements should be sent to the officer in charge for verification. Next one, postal sales. A separate register should be maintained for recording sales made by VPP, means value payable by post. The goods return should also be recorded in the VPP register. The total receipts on this account should be entered in the VPP register. In case any advance received, should be entered in the VPP register. Next one, sales by traveling agents. The traveling agent should be allowed to issue rough receipts to the customers for cash received on the sale of the articles. Final receipt should be issued only by the head officer. Agent should remit the entire proceeds to the head office, or they should deposit the cash daily in a bank. Agent should not be allowed to deduct their commission out of sale proceeds collected by them. The agent should be asked to submit periodical statements of sales, and such statements should be checked in detail. Next, head office should maintain a list of debtors and other customers. Remains should be sent to those customers who have not cleared their debts. Next one, internal check as regards to purchases. For efficient working of purchase department, its activities should be divided into the requisition, purchase order, receipt of goods, invoice, and internal check and auditor. First one, requisition. Requisition book must be kept by each department in the organization. The department requiring goods must prepare a requisition slip in duplicate by clearly mentioning the details about quality, quantity, and the time by which the goods must be supplied, and send it to the purchase department. Next one, purchase order. After receipt of requisition slip, the purchase department should invite quotations from the vendors and select the vendor who supplies quality goods at reasonable price. Then the purchase department should prepare 4 copies of purchase orders. One copy should be sent to the vendor, second to the stores, and third to the accounting department. The fact to be noted at this stage is that the purchase order should be carefully written, and it must be approved by the head of the purchase department. Next one, receipt of goods. On receipt of goods, the purchase department should carefully inspect the goods so received with the help of purchase order and invoice. Then the purchase department must enter the goods received in the goods invoice book and send the goods to the stores and should also inform the concerned department about the receipt of the goods. Next one, invoice. Purchase department should check the supplier's invoice and then send it to the accounting department for payment. The accounting department should compare the invoice with the purchase order and it should also verify the calculations. If goods received or in order and the calculations are found to be correct, proper arrangements should be made for making payment to the vendors. Next, internal check and the auditor. As the nature and scope of an auditor's work depend upon the system of internal check in operation in a concern, auditor should examine the features of the system of internal check in operation and determine whether the existing system of internal check is satisfactory or defective. If the existing system of internal check is sound, he need not undertake a detailed checking of all the transactions. He may apply test checks. However, if the existing system of internal check is defective, the auditor should carry out detailed checking of all the transactions. No doubt, when the existing system of internal check is good, auditor can rely on test checking. But the transactions selected for test checking should be examined in sufficient detail. To conclude, where there is a sound system of internal check in force in a business, the auditor can rely upon test checking. But he should use his tact, skill, experience and judgment in deciding the extent to which he could rely upon the system of internal check. Next one, internal check for departmental stores. For efficient working of departmental stores, its activities can be arranged in receipts and payments manner. First one, receipts. Receipts of cash must be handled by a cashier. As soon as cash is received, if it should be entered into a rough cash book. All the receipts in cash or check must be banked daily. This job should be done by that person who is not responsible for preparing pay in slips. Bank reconciliation statement should be prepared by the cashier to reconcile bank and cash balance. The unused receipt book should be kept under the lock and key. The counter foils of all the receipts issued should be properly maintained. The customer should be instructed to make payments by crossed checks. Customers should be advised to collect proper receipts from the head office. Automatic bills should be used for checking receipts. Next one, payments. All payments should be made by crossed checks. All vouchers should be serially numbered. All checks and bills should be scrutinized and signed by the proper authority. For all payments made, vouchers and other relevant correspondence should be checked. Petty cash payments should be handled by the petty cashier. Confirmation of accounts with creditors should be made to maintain up-to-date records. Next topic, internal audit. Internal audit is a review of operations and records undertaken within a business by specially arranged staff. It is a post-transaction review to evaluate the correctness of records and the effectiveness of operations on a continuous basis in an organization by the paying staffs. The term internal audit has been defined as the independent appraisal of activity within an organization for the review of accounting, financial and other business practices as a protective and constructive arm of management. It is a type of control which functions by measuring and evaluating the effectiveness of other types of controls. Internal audit deals primarily with accounting and financial matters, but it may also properly deal with matters of an operating nature. The work of internal auditor is more or less the same as that of external or professional auditor. Being the employee of an organization, he has to see that there is no waste and inefficiency in the organization. An auditor has to ensure that the organization incurs liabilities in respect of its valid and legitimate activities. He or she has to make efforts to find out the weaknesses of the internal control and internal check system followed in the organization and suggest necessary improvements. Many large organizations have a system of internal audit within the organization as an integral part of internal control. Internal auditing is a staff function rather than a line function, and the internal auditor doesn't exist as direct authority over other persons in the organization. So first of meaning of internal auditor. Meaning of audit, internal audit is a independent, objective, assurance and consulting activity designed to add value and improve an organization operations. The role of internal audit is to provide independent assurance that an organization's risk management, governance and internal control processes are operating effectively. Internal audit is a continuous and systematic review of the accounting, financial and other operations of the concern by the staff specially appointed for this purpose. Next one, what are the objectives of internal auditor? The main objectives of internal audit are to verify the correctness, accuracy and authenticity of the financial accounting and statistical records presented to the management, to confirm that the liabilities has been incurred by the organization in respect of its valid and legitimate activities, to comment on the effectiveness of the internal control system and the internal check system in force, and to suggest ways and means to improve these systems, to facilitate the early detection and prevention of frauds, to examine the protection effort to companies' assets and use of them for business purpose, to identify the authorities responsible for purchasing assets and other items as well as disposal of assets, to ensure that the standard accounting practices which have to be followed by the organization are strictly followed, to undertake special investigation for the management and to assist management in achieving the most efficient administration of the operation by establishing procedures by complying with the company's operating policies. Next one, what are the advantages of internal auditor? The advantages of internal audit are to ascertain whether the internal check and accounting system are adequate and effective. At the same time, to ascertain whether the predetermined policies, plans and procedures have been complied with. To evaluate the performance of personnel who are entrusted with certain responsibilities. To ascertain whether the properties of the concern are safeguarded. To suggest to the management the improvements desired in the internal check system, accounting system. Next one, disadvantages of internal auditor. Introduction of an internal audit system is quite expensive as it involves additional costs. Therefore, it is suitable only for big concern but not for the small concerns. This is the main drawback. If the internal audit system is not properly organized, it may create chaos and disorders in the working of the businesses. And internal audit is purely optional or voluntary. It is conducted in addition to external audit by the employees of the concern who may or may not be chartered accountants to ascertain whether the work of the concern is going on smoothly, efficiently and economically. Thank you.